now admins sent the e-pins to users. Now it's time to show the history of all e-pin request that is made by any action by the admin. For example, we want to show all the my internet has gone, just wait for a minute, just connecting. Okay, now it's good. For example, here is e-pin request. For those request, their status is either closed or cancelled. So those are the history for the admin. So we just want to show that information in our admin panel, so that admin can know anytime what the action they made previously. So first of all, we will create a history tab here after e-pin request. So open so inside admin folder, inside php includes, open your sidebar.php. here we will create the history tab for our e-pin. Just you can edit this one right side nav, it can be history, and it will execute the file that can be e-pin request -history.php. Done. Now we will create a file for this. So go one folder above from this location and create a file here, e-pin request history.php, inside our admin folder. It is created, and just copy the content of, we need to open another file, it should be blank.html. Not blank, it is empty.php. So we just want a empty page for our starting phase. Just copy the content of empty.php to e-pin request history.php, and it's done. And change the heading, that is e-pin request history, and also here we will change e-pin request history. It's done. Okay, it's done, and finally it's done. Okay, we don't want this ol also, just put the header. And also I need to do one more thing, it is for me. So it is just for me, as per my hosting configuration I just need to change the permission for me. Now it will work properly. Now see the output, just refresh the page, and inside this you can see history. Click on it. Now you are inside e-pin history. Now we want a table to show the all the history. As you know, in the previous video we already created it. So we will just copy the structure of this table, so that it will be very easy for us to manage it. Okay, it is done. Just open the e-pin request .php file, and copy from this card MB4. Card MB4, just copy the whole card from here and paste it to e-pin request history.php after h1 tag. Just paste it and save, and go to history page. Now it is done. Now we need to edit this. To edit, just close the file and open it again for me, e-pin request history, and it is done. Now let's refresh the page. It is done. but it is not showing any information. But here we have open status, but it is not showing any epin request. But why? It is showing my sky. Okay, we do not have any connection file yet. So just copy these both file. Sorry, this both includes code, and just paste it here. And now refresh it. It is done. Now we have to remove the action from here because it is only the history. So admin will not take any action on this page. So I will remove the action, and in place of action I can set the status so that admin will know what is the status of this epin request. Now just remove the action and remove this whole form from here and put another td. And okay, and it will be just like status. Okay, we missed one thing. Okay, we will also put the remark also above the status. It is remark, refresh the page, and it is done. The remark will show here, but it is not showing for this one. Why it is not showing? Four entries we have, 1, 2, 3, 4, and here is the remark, and it is not showing any remark here. Remark. Not showing any remark here, but why it is not showing? We have date, state. Okay, we have all the status open. Okay. We need to change it also here. That select escape from epin request, because we are on history page, so we need to check where status is not equal to open. So not equal to open, and it will show up here all the history epin request. So as you can see, like this one is closed, cancelled. As you can see, all of this here, and also the remark also, and number of event, and all the other information is here. So it is done. Okay, one more thing I want to do is that cancelled status should be show something different. So if I put any class or for any tr, that is class bg red or bg primary, what it show? Let's see. I am not sure what it will show. Okay, it's done. It will show primary like this. So we will, so we can put a condition here, like if row status equal to cancelled. What the status was here? Cancelled. The status is cancelled. In that case, we will show here echo class equal to bg danger. Let's see, refresh it, and as you can see, we have a danger sign on the cancelled status, and also the content of this row is not highlighting. So we will highlight it by changing the color of this. So just make another class, or we can set a style also, like style equal to color white. Simple. Refresh the page, and as you can see, it is now highlighting very good. And we have done the history part, like the number of epin is done, the date, the status has closed, and the epin request it is in danger. Okay, so finally it's done. So in the next tutorial we will use this epin to activate a user account from the user accounts. Okay, I will show like what we will do in the next video. I will just open the user account first, like login.php, and we have the user access for now. It was admin and password is admin. So admin the user password. Okay, we need to put the email ID, just forgot this. Okay, it's done. So in the next video we will create here the all the epin here, and after by using this epin any user will be able to activate any other user's account, as well as they can activate their account also. So, thanks for watching this video.